Been misty all day. I don't know how much moisture is actually falling. Creek's running pretty good. I've seen a lot of droplets fall, but I don't know how much actual moisture we've had today. Come on, girls. Supper time, bedtime. Let's go. Yeah, here's my girl. Abraham, there's my guy. There's my guy. Him's my Abraham. Yes, he is. Yeah, there's my Abraham. I got in the mud, in the rain, in the cold. It's not a very nice day, is it? But you're doing good. You're a good boy. You're about out of food there. About out of food. I better get him some more. So what we got here? Kind of a view of the different view of the process. My focus on this thing's got kind of funky. Alrighty. practice. I got some loose hay right out there in a haystack, and I'm going to go get some of that with a fork, and I'm going to carry it out there to Patches. I can't set this phone to where it can see all of that stuff happening at once, so I'm telling you. It's been raining for a couple days, and barnyard's pretty much all manure and mud. Places where there's a bunch of straw, like right out there in front of us, it's not straw, it's old hay, it's spoiled hay. But I put it out there because it mixes in with the mud and keeps it from sinking into my shoes, keeps me from sinking in it, and it's sticking. You can see Patches accepting that old hay, and she's eating some of it. She's got a lot of green grass, but in the winter she likes to have hay. Hay's got more nutritional density in it than grass does, because so much percentage of grass is water, and they eat that grass, they have to warm that water. Whereas when they eat the hay, even if it's been rained on like this hay, it's a much higher percentage of dry matter, total dry nutrients. So for every mouthful, she can get a little more energy to maintain her body temperature. So they like hay in the winter, even if the grass isn't covered and they, you know, have access to grass. That's all for now.